Good morning, students. Very welcome all of you to Rawal Public School. Today we will discuss here about tense. What is tense? तो बच्चों जो tense है ये tense किस लिए होता है? इसको जो definition है इसकी एक तरह से अपन इसको कहेंगे the tense which define time. Tense जो कि time को define करता है या फिर time का decision time decide करता है एक तरह से. For example This is now, यानी कि जो अभी हो रहा है. This is future, जो भविष्य में हो रहा है. This is past, जो बीत चुका, यानी कि जो ऑलरेडी हो चुका. तो गाइस जो पास्ट है ये तो आपका क्या डिसाइड कर रहा है कि जो आपको ऑलरेडी हो चुका, और जो नाउ है यानी कि ये आप लोगों के अभी जो चल रहा है, जो कंटिन्यूशन में है अभी, और जो फ्यूचर जो आप लोग इन फ्यूचर आप लोग करने वाले. ओके, हियर सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ टेंस. नाउ विल डिस्कस हियर अबाउट द टेंस काइंड्स. देयर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ टेंसेस. फर्स्ट वन इज प्रेजेंट काइंड, व्हिच आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू हियर विद द नेम ऑफ नाउ. ओके, दिस इज फॉर द नाउ. एंड सेकंड वन इज हियर फॉर पास्ट. Okay, the thing which is already happened in the past. Okay, so this you can call this as the past. And third one is future tense. Future tense, which you are going to present in future. Okay, so you can also relate it with future. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss here about present tense kinds. Guys, students, there are further four kinds are also there for the present tense. Okay, so we'll discuss here about present tense four kinds. I'm removing this. Okay students, so what we are discussing here about today? Today we will discuss about present tense. This is present tense. Okay, and in the present tense it covers four kinds. For example, this is first one is indefinite. This is indefinite, or you can also call it simple. Okay, so this simple or indefinite belongs to present tense. So what we call it? Simple present tense or present indefinite tense. Second part of present tense is continuation. This is continuous part. Okay, so how can you relate this continuous with present? You can relate it like this: present continuous tense. And the third part is perfect. Okay students, so now perfect, you can, how can you relate this present with present, present, perfect and tense. Okay, and the fourth part is here, perfect continuous. Perfect continuous. So these all are the parts which we will discuss here in today's lecture. Okay, now I'm removing all other parts because I have to explain you each topic. So today we will discuss about indefinite or the simple present tense. Okay students, so now in this simple present tense, first thing that we have to think about, the thing is that is this tense carry helping verb or not? Is this tense carry subject or not? Is this tense carry object or not? Okay, let's just discuss it about in an easy way. आज हम इसको अच्छे तरह से पढ़ेंगे. ओके, तो द फॉर्मूला फॉर द सिंपल प्रेजेंट इज सब्जेक्ट प्लस वर्ब फर्स्ट फॉर्म एंड इंक्लूडिंग इन वर्ब फर्स्ट फॉर्म यू ऑल्सो हैव टू मेंशन एस और ईएस एंड आफ्टर दिस द रिमेनिंग सेंटेंस एंड दिस रिमेनिंग सेंटेंस इज सब्स्टिट्यूट विद ऑब्जेक्ट. Okay, guys, now this S or ES, this S or ES is here for what? Okay, now we'll discuss here about like the subject. Okay, subject are two kinds of, subjects are in a two kind. This is a singular subject. Okay, and this is a plural subject. Now, what are these? In singular subject, we include he, she, it, or any proper noun. Okay, and in the plural subject, what we will include here? We'll include here I, you, we, and in the end, they. These all are the subjects, which is this is the singular subject and this is the plural subject. Okay? Now, we'll discuss here about the formula which we have put for simple present. Okay, for example, if like okay guys, I have just written here about the plural subject. Okay, now what are the uses of this S and ES? Okay guys, तो S और ES का जो use होगा वो singular subject के साथ use होगा. Okay, तो singular subjects कौन कौन से थे? He, just look at this, he, she, it, or any proper noun. Okay, so these all are the singular subjects. Okay, like for example, if I put here a singular subject plus then verbs and I also have to use S or ES and in the remaining sentence. Okay, so he, for the singular subject, I'm putting here he. Then plus, if for example, if I take verb is here for eat. So he eat. Guys, remember this. He eat mangoes. Okay, so is this sentence is correct? No, student. This sentence is wrong because subject is here singular and singular subject carries always carries S with verb. So what will be the correct sentence? He eats mangoes. Okay, and if I put here subject as a plural, okay, for example, I am putting here we as the plural subject. I already mentioned there. Okay, we, for the verb I'll take here for we go to park. Okay, now tell me this thing. We go to park. Now tell me this thing. Is this sentence is correct or not? This sentence is absolutely correct. Why? Because the subject is here plural and the verb we don't have to put S or ES because they only include with singular subjects. And if the subject is plural, then what we have to do? We just have to put the first form of the verb simply and the remaining statement. Okay, this is the indefinite or this is or the simple present which we have done. Now we'll move towards the second one. What is the second one? Could you please name the second kind of present tense? The second kind of present tense is present continuous tense. Okay, now what we will see here, this the present continuous tense include, okay, first of all the formula we put here, subject and then helping verb. Students, in the indefinite there is no that helping verb included, and in the present continuous we have to include helping verb. So subject plus helping verb plus main verb plus object. Object is for here for the remaining statement, as I already told you. Okay, so now subject is here. Okay, guys. Now what this present continuous tense carry in a helping verb? In this helping verb, it carries is, am, and are. Okay, is, am, and are. Now this as comes with singular subject. This as comes with singular subject. Okay, and are here comes with plural subject. R here comes with plural subject. Now what about am? Guys, am is the exception here. So for the am, only we are going to use am with I. What we are going to use it with? Only I. So this you have to write. Okay, so singular subject carries is, plural subject carries are, and I will carry am. Okay. Now let's phrase the sentence. The subject is like we let's have a break also. We dash. Oh, students, this includes ing form also. Okay, so we dash, and then my verb is play, for example. Okay, we play, and also again dash, we play cricket. Now how you have to phrase this sentence? Okay, now what I have to put here is am or are? You have to tell me. I am going to put here are, because are is used with plural subject, and plural subject is here we. Okay, now is the sentence is correct? No, because we are playing cricket. But in the formula, I have already put here main verb with plus ing form. So this is the main verb, and after the main verb, what I have to put? Ing form also. So playing, play will change into playing. We are playing cricket. Okay. Now we'll move towards third point. What is the come on, tell me what's the third point? The third point is present perfect. Present perfect tense. Okay. So what's the formula for present perfect tense? Here we put here like subject plus helping verb plus verb's third form. Students, remember this thing. Perfect carries verb's third form. Okay? Subject, helping verb, verb's third form plus object, the remaining sentence. Okay, now this is also carrying helping verb. Now what comes in the perfect helping verb? Here it will come as or have. Okay, now a curiosity for where to put has or where to put have. Okay, students, has we will use with singular subjects, and have we will use here with plural subjects. Okay, for the plural subject what we use have, and for the singular subject what we use has. Okay, now let's phrase the sentence. Okay, now subject, for example, they again it's a tricky it will be tricky. For example, they dash, and the verb is like here be write. Okay, for example, write. I'll not mention here because write's verb form is something else. Okay, so I'll mention here write. Okay, they dash. You have to put verb verb form in the object. They. Okay, for example, they. This is the blank for the helping verb, and this is the blank for the main verb third form, and the object is here. English paper. Okay, so which helping verb we are going to use with they? Guys, they comes in the plural subjects. So what we will use here? They have. What we will use here? They have. And now the verb is used for here for the write. So write's third form is here written. They have written. They have written English paper. Understood? Okay. Now we'll move towards the last point. That is here. Come on, you have to tell me. Come on, tell me. What is the last point? Last point is present perfect continuous tense. Okay, so what we look here, present perfect continuous tense. So first of all, we have to put here formula. Formula is like subject helping verb. Helping verb will be the same. The has and have. Has and the have. Okay. And the same formula for the verbs also. Verb third form. So subject plus helping verb plus verb third form. And now what the other thing is here? Okay. Now the remaining sentence, object. But this sentence ends with something else. How? Subject, helping verbs, verb third form. Okay, students, this will include not the verb third form. This will include not the verb third form. This will include what? This will include subject, helping verb, plus be, plus verbs, plus ing form. Okay, students, subject and the helping verb will be the has or have, plus be, plus verbs for ing form, plus object, plus since / for, and plus time. Simple. So subject has, have, plus been, plus verbs ing form, plus object, plus since / for, and plus time. Okay, now I'm phrasing the sentence here. Okay, what I'm doing here, I'm phrasing the sentence here. How to phrase a sentence? Let's take I. So for the subject, what we are taking here? We are taking here I. So I, guys, I comes in the plural subject. So what we have to use? I have been, according to formula, I have to use here been. I have been, and the verb is here study. I have been studying. Guys, study is wrong. So what you have to use? Studying. I have been studying in Rawat School. In Rawat Public School. Since 2003. Any date can be mentioned here. Like for example, since 2015. Okay, so I have been studying in Rawat Public School since 2015. So this is the formula for the present perfect continuous tense. So what we have discussed today, we have discussed here what is the meaning of tense. Tense defines time, and there are the three kinds of the tense: present tense, past tense, and the future tense. And today's lecture we have discussed here about the four kinds of the present tense, and that is simple present tense, present continuous tense, and the third is present perfect tense, and the fourth one is present perfect continuous tense. And this is all what we have done for today's lecture. Thank you.